Hello and welcome everybody to a special kind of video clip. Today we are going to have some fun with IndustrialCraft TNT. Let's put our sound just a little bit slower because this is going to get a little bit explosive. Why did I want to do this episode, this video? Because with mods out there like Equivalent Exchange and nowadays Thumbcraft, it's getting harder and harder for people to play around with TNT. So I'm thinking, you know what, these guys don't know how fun TNT is. Now, as you know, we are in... Oh, not like that. We are in a 1.2.3 Minecraft, 1.2.3. So that basically means I can't really show you the recipes for these live, so we'll have to do them in by hand. Okay. Let's get started, shall we? And one of these, thank you. The most important thing to know about industrial TNT and dynamite is that it does not destroy, like normal TNT, it does not destroy the blocks that it dislodges, okay? So, for example, this over here, this wall, every single piece of gold that is going to be blown up by the TNT will fall on the ground. Okay, the normal TNT, as you know, destroys some of it. Be very, very careful when placing it, because if you punch it, yes, it goes off. And I have magnetic mode on. Okay, what you see here is a pretty big blast radius, and as you can see, there's like, we had it over here somewhere, over there, so that's a 1, 2, 3, 4 ish on that side, maybe another 4 on this side. So basically it's a pretty big hole. Okay, let's go into creative a little bit. All right, and now let's go in a little bit deeper. Okay, so if we go one inside, the hole starts getting smaller. As you can see, there is a 3x3 gap in here. Okay, we had it, the TNT was in here, okay, in that block. So it starts to get a little more precise, okay, once you go inside. Let's go inside to this time, so like that. And as you can see, all the things, all the blocks are getting into my inventory. And now you can actually see how precise this guy gets, okay? So it was here, okay? And it was surrounded a 9x9 cube, basically. So yeah, it gets pretty precise, okay? Let's try that again. And there you have it. So apparently lapis has a different blast resistance than gold. Oh, I see you there. There you go. Anyway, so that's for normal TNT blocks, okay? Now let's talk about dynamite. We have the standard dynamite that comes with a remote control. You right click on it to select it basically, and then right click again. And again, and again, and apparently my IndustrialCraft had crashed. Okay, let me get back to you once I figure this out. Okay, so we are back. Apparently being in creative doesn't play well with the dynamite from IndustrialCraft. Oh, and we are raining outside. No worries, no worries. So, as I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, yay! This actually is a more precise, even more precise dynamite TNT, because you can basically play around like this. Okay, so you put one here, you leave how many? Two spaces, like that, and another two, and like that. You select every one, be sure to select them like that. And then when you do like that, more, even more precise. Another cool feature of dynamite and TNT in industrial craft is the fact that it doesn't do much damage to the player. So it's as safe as TNT can become. So first of all, it gives you all the items back, and second of all, it doesn't hurt you as much. So that's two awesome things right there. Let's do that this again because I like it. Select. You might imagine that after a while, selecting every and each one of them becomes a little bit tiresome. Okay, so here's where sticky dynamite comes into place. Let me just put one in there. And we have sticky dynamite. It has the same effect as the normal dynamite. You just need to throw them one by one. So you can't have controlled explosion on like a normal mineshaft or something like that. Okay, let's do the recipes for these guys, shall we? Let me get some recipes. And look at that. Nice. First of all, we need a crafting table. Okay, second of all, we need some flint, right? We need some sand, and we need some gunpowder from creepers. Okay, let's put our crafting table down, and four sand like that, five gunpowder like that gets us a normal TNT, a vanilla TNT. Okay, if we get three of these guys, okay, and put them like that with some flint, we get four industrial craft TNT. Okay, these guys with some string, if I remember correctly, string. Can I discard this? Four. Okay, we got some dynamite. Okay, so let's delete this. Okay, so 16 and 16 again, 32 dynamite. Right, and with some sticky resin from Industrial Craft, like that. We get ourselves 32 sticky dynamite. Okay, I already had some in my inventory, so don't worry about that. Yay! So from 3 TNT, vanilla TNT, you get 32 dynamite, which is actually pretty awesome. Now let's go and test some more things with this dynamite. First of all, I wanted to test if I can throw with a red power deployer some dynamite, some sticky dynamite. Okay, so let's search here, frequency 5. Okay, and then pulse. And there you have it, people. You can deploy dynamite with red power. Which is actually pretty awesome. Let's try that again. There you have it. Okay, so now that we saw that we can deploy that, can I do some sort of fireworks, please? So if I put one that's facing up with some sticky dynamite and press again. Well, apparently not. Which is kind of a bummer. We could do something like carpet bombing. Okay, so vertical down, but vertical up, it doesn't work for us. Which is kind of not nice. If you have any more experiments that could result in a makeshift fireworks display, please make a video response and throw it on the internets, because I love to see those. Okay, getting down to business with these people, with this deployer, we have the usual use for dynamite for TNT, and that is making mine shafts. Okay, let's see again. Frequency 5. Okay. Whoop. Pardon me. As you can see, once if it is on the surface, okay, it makes a pretty big hole. Okay, and once you go deep and put it with blocks around it, it starts getting more and more precise. So we don't need that. We just need to have some fun and make a mineshaft very, very fast. Okay. And you can see the fun in this. And because I have the remote control, pardon me. And because I have the remote control mod installed, if I can find it, remote, please. There you have it. So, pulsing on frequency 5. I pulse with P, just so you know. Just to show you that it doesn't destroy anything, let's leave it like that and we'll go after that. And you'll see that the diamonds start multiplying because it doesn't destroy them. And we'll have lots and lots and lots of diamonds. Let's get out of creative to test the power of the explosion. I'm on peaceful, but as you can see, it only took one heart of damage. There you go. So let's put us in normal, actually do some proper testing. Still one heart of damage. And as you can see, the diamonds are getting more and more. Okay, let's turn magnetic on. I love that. Okay. More diamonds! More dynamite! More diamonds! Come on! And bam. Let's spam this, see if it works. I love that so much. Let's put ourselves in peaceful because this is getting ridiculous. Why do I keep doing this? Because I want to show you guys that this TNT actually has a limit, and that limit basically is a shorter fuse, as it says on the wiki. So as you can see, it has reached some sort of limit. Now it doesn't even reach the ground, it just explodes in midair. Let's watch it. Bam! Again. And boom! Make it daytime. So this is basically the limit for the IndustrialCraft TNT. Actually, I can do this, can't I? Yeah. Noobish, I know. Noob. Total noob. I have some diamonds stuck in the wall here. Anyways, so let's mark this point with some obsidian. Just to show you, just to give you an idea of the limits of IndustrialCraft TNT. Limits as in limits for mine shafting. Okay, is that okay? I think it is. Can I go one more here? And here as well. There you have it. Okay, let's go up there and put some regular TNT now. TNT. Okay, and let's get back down. Now, for this purpose, I'm going to keep it in creative, because as you know, the regular TNT is quite destructive even for the player. And as you can see, the regular TNT reached the bottom, and let's turn off magnetic. So basically, with regular TNT, you can go to the bottom of the map, which is 64 blocks before it explodes. While with IndustrialCraft TNT, I have counted, and there's a limit of about 44 blocks until it detonates. Okay, let's get this faster, please. Yeah, so basically, though, that is higher than 64. So with regular TNT, you go pretty much down to the bottom of the map. What you can also see is the fact that Industrial TNT has a very, very precise range. Okay, so that is how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So that's a circle, that's 11 by 11. Okay, and what you can see up here, this contraption, that basically helps me deploy the TNT very, very precisely. Because as you know, when we hit the TNT at the beginning of the video, it tended to wobble around. Okay, so this puts the TNT, and the TNT stays within exactly this block when it falls, and that allows me to make a very, very, very nice mineshaft. as you can see. I think this is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I know I did, even though I'm sorry guys, but when I concentrate on things, even though they are really really fun to me, my voice doesn't seem to express that. Maybe for you guys it seems that I am bored, or I don't know, I tend to become very very serious, but it's actually very very enjoyable. So a lot of very very. I'm not that of a expressive in my speech, and of course with my English being as it is, hope you enjoyed. Please rate, comment and subscribe, and as always, don't forget to be awesome guys. Ciao.